हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। इन दिस चैप्टर देयर विल बी फाइव लेक्चर्स। टुडे इज द फोर्थ। वन मोर लेक्चर इज टू बी कंप्लीटेड एंड दैट विल बी अ सॉल्यूशन ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द काइनेमेटिक सिंथेसिस। द स्टेजेज ऑफ काइनेमेटिक सिंथेसिस वी हैव डिस्कस। व्हाट इज काइनेमेटिक सिंथेसिस, हाउ द various stages of kinematic synthesis means design are to be performed, we will discuss. So there are three stages of kinematic synthesis. Number one is the type synthesis. It refers to the type of mechanism which we are going to choose for the design. So it refers to the kind of mechanism such as gear combination. There are various types of gears which we have already discussed. So which type of gearing we are using, or the combinations of gears we are using, whether bevel gears, spur gears, helical gears, worm gears. So it depends upon the type of mechanisms, such as combination of gears, belt pulley combination, whether we are using V belt, flat belt, like that, whether it is open belt drive or cross belt drive, like that, or cam mechanism. You have also gone through the cam mechanism, various types of cams, various types of followers you have gone through. So type synthesis refers to the type of mechanism which we are opting for the design. For example, whether we are using gear combinations, whether we are using pulley combinations or cam mechanism. So this is the type of synthesis. Type means types, various types of mechanisms. Number two is the number synthesis. Number synthesis, what is the number of movability, what is the degree of freedom, etc. So the number synthesis, it depends upon the external parameters such as number of links, how many number of links are there, because degree of freedom is related to the number of links directly. F is equal to 3 n minus 1 minus 2 p minus h, like that. So that is the Grubler's equation. So we will make use of Grubler's equation in determining the number synthesis. And number synthesis will depend upon the number of links, number of pairs, P, H, etc. It also depends upon the number of joints, ternary joint, quaternary joints, etc. We have gone through that type of analysis earlier. So number synthesis depends upon the number of links. It also depends upon the number of joints. It depends upon the number of pairs, etc. So that is the number synthesis. And it depends upon number of links, pairs, joints, number of links, pairs, joints, and we will surely make use of Grubler's criteria. We will make use of the Grubler's criteria also. Third is Dimensional synthesis. Under this heading, we will determine the various dimensions of the mechanism. That is the dimensional synthesis. Third is dimensional synthesis. Dimensional synthesis. Under this heading, we will find the various dimensions of the mechanism, such as in case of four bar mechanism, we will determine the values of A, B, C and the various arms of the mechanism. So that is the determination or computation of dimensions of the link so that the mechanism may accomplish the specified work. We determine the dimensions, determine the dimensions of various links, dimensions of various links. We determine the dimensions of various links so that the mechanism, is capable of doing, doing a particular or specified work. There are three types of errors present in the design of linkages. Errors which are caused in the design of linkages are of three types: structural error, mechanical error, and graphical error. There are three types of error in the design of linkages. That is graphical error. First we will discuss the mechanical error, and then graphical error, and finally structural error. Mechanical error is caused because of mechanical defects. Mechanical errors are caused because of mechanical defects such as improper machining, improper casting of components, overloading of links, etc. So, mechanical error is caused because of improper casting, it is caused because of improper casting, improper machining, overloading of links, links or components, etc. This is mechanical defect. And graphical defect will be because of errors in the proper choice of scale. There may be manual defects in making the drawings, or it is caused due to inaccuracy of drawing.
It is caused due to inaccuracy of drawing or improper selection of scale,
or there may be manual errors in making the drawings. There may be wrong graphical construction. So mechanical errors is caused because of mechanical defects such as improper casting, improper machining or overloading of links, etc. Graphical error is caused because of inaccuracy in the drawing, not proper selection of the scale, or using graphical or wrong graphical constructions or making wrong graphical constructions. So these are the defects. Other defect is structural error. Structural error, it can be understood with the help of structural error. Structural errors. This is Y naught, X naught, X one, Y one, X two, this is Y two. This is Y3. And this is Y n plus 1. This is X n plus 1. There is a correlation between the motion of the output and input link. There is correlation between the motion of input link and output link. There is correlation between the motion of input link and output link. The motion of input link is indicated by X naught, X one, X two, and X n plus one. Similarly, and the corresponding motion of output link
corresponding motion of output link is indicated. Output link is indicated by y naught, y one, y two, dash dash dash, yn plus one. This is the corresponding motion of the output link.
So x parameter, x naught, x two, x three is independent of y. Another, you can say the y parameter is independent on x parameter. So the graph can be presented like this.
X naught, corresponding motion output link is y naught. X one, the motion of the input link, and the motion of the, or the corresponding motion of the output link is indicated by y one. Similarly, x2 is the motion of the input link, and the corresponding motion of the output link is indicated by y2, and so on.
So the graph is projected like this. So if we join all these points, as shown in the figure, it is known as generated function.
It is known as generated function.
Also, a curve can be drawn, which is known as desired function. So the desired function can be like this. This is the desired function.
Desired function. For the design of links,
the generated function will be obtained at the intersection of x and y coordinates. And the desired function can also be drawn for the design of components which agrees well at certain points, such as at this point. This is now, suppose this is P naught, where generated function and desired function agree well, that is known as precision points. From the figure you can see, at point P naught, suppose this point is P naught, this is known as precision point. At the intersection of x1 and y1 coordinate, it is shown as P1. It is known as precision point. P naught, P1, P naught, P1, and suppose this is P2, are the precision point. These are known as precision point. The points where the generated function, which is obtained because at the intersection of x and y coordinates, and the desired function intersect, is known as precision points. We assume that at these points there is no error. Here there is no error. This is a precision point. Here there is no error, but here it is not agreeing. Supposing at this point it is not matching, or there is no agreement, so this point is known as structural error. Where the curve where the generated function and desired functions do not agree, rather they vary by certain amount of curve, is known as structural error. At rest of the points where generated function and desired functions agree is known as precision point. So precision points are those points where the generated function and desired functions agree well, as you can see from the figure, P naught, P2 and P1. There are certain other points also where the generated function and the desired functions do not agree.
rather they are, there is a deviation by certain amount, as you can see at this point 3. So at point 3 there is certain error. This error is known as structural error. So structural error is equal to, structural error is the generated function minus desired function. Structural error is, these are the precision points, there is no doubt about it. P0, P1 and P2 are the precision points where the generated function and desired functions meet. Desired function is, we want this type of design. But there are certain points where the design and generated functions do not agree. Those points are known as structural errors. So structural error is equal to generated function because of the intersections of x and y coordinates minus generated function minus desired function. That is the structural error. Our try as an engineer designer is that the structural error should be as minimum as possible. We will work on this concept. So that is, there are three types of errors. Structural error, mechanical error because of mechanical defects, improper casting was one of the main reasons. Overloading of components was another reason like that. Graphical error because of the error in the drawings or wrong selection of scales leads to the graphical error. Structural error is the generated function minus desired function. These are the points where the generated function and the desired functions do not agree. And at rest of the points, they are agreeing, which are known as precision points. What is function generation? Another term is function generation. I have already sent the material in the form of papers or photocopy of a book regarding these various items which I am discussing. So you can go through those pages also. One more lecture is to be there. It will be next week or this week, and after that this chapter will be complete. And then we will have a test from this chapter. And the test most probably will be of numerical type. There will be one example, one numerical problem in the examination from this chapter. And I am sure that rest of the chapters, CAMS, Belt and Ropes, have already been completed by Dr. Tejbir Kaur in the class. Still, if you have any problem, you can discuss with me. You can send your doubts to me on the WhatsApp group and I will clarify each and everything. Next is function generation. What is function generation? It is like this. Function generation is like this. It is a 4-bar mechanism. We normally take this angle as theta 4. We have already used this term in the equation, in the Friedenstein equation. The input angle was taken as theta 2. Output angle was taken as theta 4. It is extended to this position. Or suppose this is y1, this is y2, and here also it is x1, it is x2. This arm is A, this arm is B, this arm is C, and this dimension is also T. This is known as output link. Output link. This is known as input link. Theta 2 is the angle made by the input link with the frame. Theta 4 is the angle made by the output link with the frame, theta 4. And A, B, C and D are the various dimensions of the links. So, in function generation, the motion of the input link is correlated to the motion of the output link. The motion of the input link, input link is correlated. The motion of the input link is correlated to the motion of the output link. Output link. The input link AB rotates through angle theta 2. This is AB. C and this is A. The input link AB rotates through angle theta 2 in the anticlockwise direction like this. And the output link CD rotates by angle theta 4 in the anticlockwise direction as shown. BC is the coupler. The link or the input link AB rotates through angle theta 2 and represents independent variable X and indicates independent variable X. Similarly, the output link CD rotates through angle theta 4 and represents dependent variable Y. Here Y is dependent on X. Assuming X1 and X2 as the initial and final positions of dependent variable X. It is assumed that theta 2 final minus theta 2 initial divided by x2 minus x1 is equal to constant. It is assumed that theta 2 final minus theta 2 initial divided by x in the final shape minus x1 in the initial shape, their ratio is taken as constant. Similarly, theta 4 f minus theta 4 I is equal to y2 minus y1 is equal to constant. is equal to constant, it is accepted
and it is assumed.
Suppose the initial position of the link is theta 2i. It is like this. And the corresponding displacement or the motion of the input link is x1. After such a time, theta 2i becomes theta 2f, that is final. This is initial. Suffix f indicates final, I indicates initial. Theta 2f minus theta 2y divided by x2 minus x1, it is assumed that it is constant. And this concept is also applicable in the case of rotation of the output angle, output link. Theta 4f minus theta 4i divided by y2 minus y1 is also kept as constant. So, we will make this the use of this concept in the solution of certain numerical problems. Y1 and Y2 are the initial and final positions of dependent variable Y. Similarly, X1 and X2 are the initial and final values of X, or independent variable X. Similarly, Y1 and Y2 are the initial and final values of dependent variable Y. X1 and X2 are the initial and final values of independent variable X. So, this relation or the ratio of the angles theta 2f minus theta 2i divided by x coordinate, that is x2 minus x1, is constant. Similarly, for the output link rotation, their ratio with their motions is also constant. So, we will make use of this concept or this relation in the solution of various numerical problems. We will use one relation in the design of mechanisms, that is known as Chebyshev spacing. Chebyshev spacing. We will have precision points.